My approach has always been, let's not divide this city. Let's find a way to make this very diverse city work well. And it's not easy, and it takes a lot of work and a lot of listening. It takes a lot of lessons in humility, to be honest with you. And it's trying to make sure that you're governing the whole city and not components or segments of the city. And I think that's the challenge that a good president accepts, that you don't pit people against each other. And I think that's been one of the challenges or one of the failings of President Trump, is that he relishes the opportunity to pit people against each other.
The state is very wired right now after Kenosha, and I know Madison had trouble during the George Floyd protests. As a mayor, does it feel like you're sitting on a tinderbox or?
On a tightrope. You're on a tightrope all the time because you've got so many different factions, and police obviously are at the center of all this right now. In large cities, in all cities, you're always going to have a part of the population that might feel estranged from the police department. There might be tensions there.
Yeah.
So you're always going to have a diverse community, and you're always going to have the police. That's just going to happen. It's like a marriage or a long-term relationship, and you have to work at it. The work is never done, and it's how do you create trust? And that's the challenge. That's the challenge that we have.
If you're Biden, what should that team be most worried about or what most concerns you?
I think people still respond best to hope. They feel it's going to get better. Mm-hmm. And certainly if it does get better, that's the ultimate way to do it. So I think he has, and I think he's trying to, and I think his life practice is to try to create the hope. And so I encourage them to continue to give people something to vote for as well as to vote against. I mean, everybody can say, we don't like Trump, but there's a lot of people who do like Trump. So that message doesn't always resonate.
Yes, there are.
You have to give people something to vote for as well.
Yeah. I mean, the state is always so razor thin to begin with.
This is the ultimate purple state. And every election has been decided by a razor thin margin. And I anticipate that will occur this time as well.
Kenosha, very tough situation. Madison already had a tough situation. This is not ending. But leaving here, it does feel like Biden still may have an advantage in this state.
I don't think anybody should be cocky about the state of Wisconsin at all. I think it's a battleground, and it's going to remain a battleground till 8 o'clock on November 3rd. there's no doubt in my
mind. Probably a week after, right?
Probably a week after.